So in today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you five tools that every virtual assistant must have. If you do not have any of these tools, if you do not know how to operate any of these five tools, then you need to go back to the drawing board. Okay, so basically these are not five tools, but these are, I've been able to group them into five categories just so that it's easy for you to understand, so that it's easy for you to understand what they are meant for. So let's get right started. But before we start, I want to make this announcement. If you're actually good at social media marketing, my client is looking for a social media manager, social media manager who's going to handle LinkedIn, YouTube, and Facebook, these three apps, as it's a B2B. So if you feel like you have what it takes and you have a portfolio and you can defend what you've done, then just send me a message on LinkedIn. Send me a message on LinkedIn or a link to your resume and portfolio, something like that, or the PDF, I guess, and I will put in a word for you. Note that the time is limited. I want to be able to put in a word for you before she actually finds someone herself. So on the other notes, I want to thank three people. Well, I want to thank Chimna, Dindo, Mary Jane, and Kome. I appreciate that you're putting comments in, you're asking your questions in the comment section, and I hope I've been able to answer your questions. I know that I think the three of you, one thing you have in common is that you need answers on how to create a gig on Fiverr. So I'm going to be not making a video, rather I'm going to be having a live session, and then I'm going to walk you through the steps of how to create your gig on Fiverr. So if just to confirm, I just want to confirm, if you're really still interested in learning how to create a gig on Fiverr, please put it in the comment section so that I know how many people I'm going to, I'm looking forward to, I'm seeing in the live session. And please be watchful of when I'm going to schedule a live session, because it's going to take a little bit of time, so I'm going to have to do it on the YouTube live. Don't forget to subscribe if you're actually seeing this video for the first time, and if you like what you see, if you're interested, if you feel like you've actually gained value from any of my videos, please like, and also tell me in the comment section that I'm doing well. I actually appreciate. So thank you, Chimna, Dindo, Kume, and Mary Jane, thank you so much. So let's get started. So the first tool that I'm going to mention is actually a tax management software. So what is a tax management software? Well, the name is actually quite self-explanatory. A tax management software is a software that helps you as a virtual assistant manage the tax that will be assigned to you or have been assigned to you, right? So in this tax management, it's easy to organize your tax. It's easy to see all of the things that you're supposed to do, that you have done, and that you are working on right now. So some of this tax management softwares, example of this tax management softwares are Trello, Asana, Jira, and even monday.com. So if I'm going to repeat them, Trello, Asana, monday.com, Jira. So if you're listening to me right now and you don't even know what I'm talking about, I want you to take some time out and at least choose one or two of these softwares and create an account. They all have free versions. Create an account and get familiar with how they work. There are a lot of YouTube videos on them. But if you feel like they are very confusing, overwhelming, feel free to tell me what you think about them on the comments, and then I'm going to definitely answer you. So the reason why you need to know at least two is that although these platforms are quite technically similar, they have their differences, they have their use, and certain clients have preferences. For example, my last client and I worked on Asana, and my current client and I work on monday.com. I actually told her I've never used monday.com, but because I know how Jira, Trello and Asana works, I definitely know I'm going to find it easy or not too difficult to understand how monday.com works. Okay, so it's important that you know at least two, just get familiar with it. In case if you get a client who doesn't work with any of them, then it will be easy for you to actually understand what they do. Now, the second tool that I'm going to mention is communication tool. Yeah, so communication tools rather. Communication tools are tools that allow you to, again, communicate with your clients. So this might be WhatsApp, but the truth is that most foreign clients are not on WhatsApp. Very few of them are actually on WhatsApp. So most times they prefer to communicate differently. So I'm talking about communicating on email or Slack, Teams, Zoom, Google Meet. It's important that you are not confused when you come on Zoom with a client and they are telling you to unmute yourself and you don't even know where the unmute button is. So you need to get familiar with these platforms so that we don't look like dummies, right? So even if you know your stuff, you at least need to know how to handle these tools that you are going to be working with. Now, the third platform or tool that I'm going to mention, the third category that I'm going to mention is a calendar or scheduling tools. Now, these tools are very important because every business owner needs to have the calendar that they're working with so as to organize their schedule. Yeah. So usually you need to know how calendars work. I mean, Google calendars or Microsoft calendar or even calendar scheduling platforms like Calendly or PeakTime, or you can book me or Acuity or a lot of other scheduling platforms that exist. You need to be able to understand how they work or even help your client link their scheduling platforms to their calendar, or even help your client organize all of the individual calendars they have into one calendar. So calendars or scheduling tools actually help clients with tracking their appointments, scheduling appointments, understanding deadlines if possible. So if you're going to be working as a virtual assistant with a client, it's important you understand how they work. Now, the fourth category that I'm going to be mentioning is cloud storage tools. So cloud storage tools are simply tools that help people manage their files, their documents, or store their files or documents in the cloud, right? So there are, when we're talking about this, we're talking about Google Drive, OneDrive, Dropbox, and so many other storage platforms out there. These are actually the most popular cloud storage tools out there. So you need to understand how they work. If someone sends you a file, a Google Drive file, a OneDrive file, or a folder, what is the difference? What do you do? How do you upload? If they send you a document, a folder link, how do you download if they do all of these things? So it's important that you actually understand how this cloud storage tools work. You also need to know how to open folders, how to open files, how to group files, where to find files. I mean, if someone gives you an access to their Google Workspace and they say, oh, can you help me get this particular file, and it's in the sheets, right? Or it's a spreadsheet, or what's the easiest way to find this file, right? So we need to figure out how these things work. Now, the next thing that I'm going to be mentioning, I feel it's very, very important. And now these are collaborative document tools. And when I mean by collaborative document tools are tools such as Microsoft Word, Google Docs, Microsoft Excel, Google Sheets, PowerPoint, Google Slides. These are collaborative document tools that you need to understand how they work. It doesn't, you know how small a document is, Microsoft document, a Word document actually is, but the Word document can do so many things, same as Excel. So you need to know how these platforms work. And because you are going to be working as a virtual assistant, you need to know how the online version works and not the Word 2007 cracked version that your local computer guy would install in your laptop. So I'm talking about the online versions of all of these collaborative document tools. It will help you, because if your client says, okay, can you please find out how, you know, who's doing this or where I can find this, you need to submit it in a document. And the easiest way, we're not talking about sending them a PDF file. The easiest way is to share that document to them online so that they can make, you know, live corrections to that document. Okay, so you need to be able to. And then the second thing I wanted to mention is that as much as you actually know Microsoft very well, you actually need to like familiarize yourself with Google's tools. Because I am saying this because the last client I worked with, we worked on Microsoft. So everything we did while working on while working with her was on Microsoft. I'm talking about Microsoft Word, PowerPoint, Excel, Teams. Meanwhile, the current person I'm working with is a fan of Google, and so we're doing everything on Google Workspace, including, you know, Google Meet and everything. So you need to be quite familiar. They're not so different, but being familiar with these things, at least you know you'll not be stranded, especially when you're working like live with the person, right? Because I mean, if you're actually out doing your thing without the person there in the Zoom meeting with you, you can figure things out. But if the person is there in the meeting with you, you really need to be able to be delivering, finding documents fast, creating documents fast, creating tables as fast as possible. Now, the bonus points that I'm going to give you, which is the sixth category that's supposed to be your best friend as you're navigating your virtual assistant career, is AI. Now, I'm not going to say ChatGPT, because ChatGPT is not the only AI that exists. There are a lot of them. There is Grammarly. You can just install Grammarly to your Chrome extension or whatever extension, whatever browser you're using, and then it helps with the language. I mean, they have a free version, so it helps edit, you know, manage your grammar. There are other AIs out there. There's Writer, there's Jarvis AI, there are Gemini, Google now has AI, and so there's AI everywhere. Literally everywhere. So you need to like get acquainted with working with AI. AI can help you write letters better. Of course, you're not copying exactly what AI told you, but it can help you, give you pointers. Even to research, when you're trying to research, AI can help you, give you pointers on how to go about certain things. Now, these tools that I've mentioned are going to help enhance your productivity significantly. Personally, it helps personal development, and it's going to help tell or communicate your client or potential client that you actually are tech savvy. Yes, that's the meaning of at least basic tech savvy, right? You're not a coder or anything, but these tools, the knowledge of these tools, are really, really going to help you. So I hope that I was able to communicate the best tools that you need to have. You need to know how they work right now. So if you've not yet subscribed to my channel, please click on the subscribe button. I appreciate. And if you feel like I gave you value, feel free to like my video. And if you have any question or any video you would like me to do, please put it in the comment section. Again, I'm going to be scheduling a live for how to create a gig on Fiverr. And so just to confirm, if you're actually up for it, please put it in the comment section, and so that when I schedule that live, I can also come and remind you in the comment section. Thank you, and see you next time.